Guys, welcome back to my channel. Today I'm going to be deep cleaning and decorating my master bathroom, but before we get started I wanted to let you guys know that if you sign up using the link below you will be able to get all of these Mrs. Meyers products for free. That includes a hand soap, a dish soap, and a hand lotion, as well as the caddy. So check out the link below. If you are a new Grove customer you will be able to get all of these products for free. And now let's go ahead and start cleaning. So I'm going to be using this Mrs. Meyers surface scrub to clean off my sink countertops. I find that this does a really good job when I need a nice deep clean on my countertops. Glass and surface cleaner to clean off the sink faucets as well as the mirror. And as you can see, I really like the product because it's almost gone. Off my cabinets using just Dawn dish soap, and then I'm going to rinse the cloth out with water. I feel like Dawn does a really good job of just taking off any grime that are stuck on the cabinets, maybe toothpaste, anything sticky from my kids' hands. It does a really good job of cleaning them off well. Cleaner. It really helps to get hard water stains off of almost anything, so I love to use this on the shower glass door. My husband is not the best squeegee-er, so hard water gets stuck on our door really easily, and this takes it off so wonderfully. And as you can see in the reflection, I have a really good helper. He loves to help me clean, so I gave him the task of cleaning off the bathroom window. Next, I'm going to be cleaning off the bottom of the shower using this Mrs. Meyers baking soda cream cleanser. I feel like this does a really good job of removing any kind of stains or soap that it has sat on the bottom of the shower. So now I'm using the Mrs. Meyers tub and tile cleaner to spray off and clean the tiles in the shower. ¶¶ out the bathtub using the same Mrs. Meyers surface scrub that I used for the countertops. Tried these Clorox toilet wands that I rave about, you have to try them. My kids love to clean the toilet with these, and so I'm going to go ahead and let Carter clean the toilet. Product before, but if you have boys, this Clorox urine remover is a must-have. I will usually spray this all around the perimeter of the toilet and usually most of the floor just to make sure that I get any pee that misses the toilet. Method squirt and mop cleaner to clean off the floor. I'm not going to use my mop because I want to get it just a little bit more of a deeper clean, so I'm actually getting down on my hands and knees and cleaning the floor. So in order to make the bathtub area look a little bit more organized, I found this basket at Home Goods, and I'm just going to put all of my usual bath products that sit out near my bathtub in the basket. Hanging up this sign that I found at an antique shop probably a year ago, and I just love how distressed and chippy it looks, and I think I paid like $18 for it, I think, but I'm gonna put it up there above the tub. I can't really show you because see how it gets dark whenever I show the, see when I go from there to up there, so I'm gonna put it up there above the window. It's just gonna be hard to show you because it gets dark when it sees the light. So that's what it looks like up there. I'm trying to show you the best that I can in this lighting. So that's what it looks like up there. Okay, so I found this at the same antique slash, I don't know what you wanna call it. I don't know that they're all antiques. It's just kind of like a thrift place, I don't know. And I had this up here before, so I'm just putting it right back up there, but it was super cheap, so if you can find something like this, probably at Hobby Lobby. This is a really cute little thing to put above your bathtub and store whatever you want up here, but I just like how it brings a little bit of dimension to the bathroom. Instead of just putting something flat up on the wall, I like how it gives it a little bit of dimension and some texture. Are from Hobby Lobby, and they were $18 a piece, which makes them $9 if you go when all their signs are half off. So $9 each, and I'm gonna set these up here on top of this. Now, this is from Home Goods, and I was gonna say I might still have a tag on it, but I don't. This was probably $12 or so. I had this in my hutch, and I'm just gonna move it in here because I like the soft colors of it, and I think it would just go really good in here. The purple makes brings out just a little bit of color, but not too much, but I love how lavender looks in the bathroom. So I'm gonna set this right up here, right here, right here in the middle. One is from TJ Maxx, I believe, and I liked the white, almost milk glass looking jar on here, and then the lamb's ear stems. I just think that this looks really pretty. I like the soft look of greenery like this. If you're trying to come up with things to put in your bathroom, greenery is always a good idea, and if you're kind of going with this color scheme, this color. These really light color petals look really pretty and they almost look real. So another idea that you can use in a thing like this or really any space in your bathroom is these hand towels, and you can roll them up and put them almost like a decoration. These are actually hand towels that we use, but I will just grab them from there and just kind of replace them. You can buy hand towels specifically just for decoration if you want. I like that they don't look the same, and you could definitely do three if the area that you're looking for fits. I like to do things in odds. Another way that you can decorate is using apothecary jars like this and putting in cotton balls or the cotton swabs inside of them, or really anything else that you want. I just like how cotton balls look, or cotton swabs. I have another apothecary jar right here, and this one has a few cotton swabs left in it. So you can use these to decorate with. Another thing that you can use to decorate with is candles, but this one is just from TJ Maxx and it's by DW Home and it smells really, really good. Also got this really pretty hand towel from Target. I just really like the tassels at the bottom of it. I thought it was really pretty. And then that very, very light touch of light blue. I just thought it was really pretty. And I like decorative hand towels. You know, of course we use them and they get dirty, but I just think that they add a little bit of a pretty touch to the bathrooms. So another thing that I like to have in the bathroom are pretty bathroom rugs. And it took me a little while to find one that I liked just because I didn't like how it fit the space. So if you have a long cabinet area like this, and I am going to be painting these cabinets white, stay tuned for that because they're definitely getting chipped down here. So my next project, since I just finished painting the walls in here, is going to be to paint these cabinets. But anyways, we're talking about the rug. So this rug is from Amazon. It was very, very inexpensive and I love it. I highly recommend it. They do have other colors if this is your style or if this is not your style. So I will leave the link to this below and you guys can order one. If you're looking for a long rug, kind of like this one, I love it. It definitely masks any, you know, stains or whatever that you might get on here, but it's held up so well and I really recommend it. This caddy is from Target. As you can see, it is the Threshold brand. And I used to have a three-tiered thing up here, but it was really driving me crazy. I felt like it looked really cluttered because you could just see everything. And then I saw this when I was at Target and I thought, how cool is that? You can put your straightener in there. It's got this little hole for a straightener. You could do toothbrushes. It's got another hole here for, you know, another hair product or hairbrush or whatever you want. And then it's got three more compartments right here for other things. So it's just enough to store your stuff on top of the sink, but look organized. And this is also a really pretty wood color. I love it. Okay, so here's how much cleaner and nicer that looks. I can put like my straightener and stuff in here. I think I'm just gonna do my hairbrush for now, but I know that I have a habit of leaving my straightener out, which could definitely go under my cabinet, but I think that I will probably end up putting it in here just because it's a habit to always leave it out. And to have a space to just kind of drop it in is nice. So I will probably stick that in that one or something. I just don't want my Cash, dude, what are you doing? I'm trying to talk. You are just crazy today. Can you say hi? I also like to have some nice hand soaps to go in my bathroom. So right now I've got the Mrs. Meyers mint on both sides, but it's usually always a Mrs. Meyers soap in the bathroom. And then also a hand lotion, which I think I'm gonna put in this middle spot right here. That way I have a hand lotion in the bathroom. So you guys can get your hand soap and hand lotion, as well as the caddy and the dish soap, all for free when you sign up with Grove. So definitely check out the link below if you want your free products. And then to add just a little bit of color to the space, I'm gonna be adding another pot of greenery. You cannot go wrong with greenery. I took the tag off this one too, but I believe this is from either Home Goods or TJ Maxx. That's where I get most of my greenery from. And I wanna say probably TJ Maxx, but I just like how pretty real that this looked. I'm just gonna put this here in here in the corner of the bathtub just to kind of give it a little pop of color. So that is it for this video. I hope you guys enjoyed deep cleaning and decorating the bathroom with me. Hopefully it gave you some ideas of how you can decorate your bathroom at home, as well as give you a little bit of motivation to get some cleaning done. And don't forget to check out the link below to get your Grove products for free when you sign up. And I will see you guys all next time. Bye.